Okay,
Yeah, live.
we're live now. All right, hi everybody. Welcome to another Verbling class. This is going to be a speaking class, but instead of just talking and having a conversation, we're going to let you guys do some role playing. So I've created a few scenarios where we'll get a little bit of background information, and then you guys will take turns playing different roles and improvising. So you're going to be making some stuff up. But we're also going to help you guys, so if you get stuck, we can provide some things for you to consider. So let me go to, let's see here, who's, hello, hello. Hi there, Ate, how are you?
I'm doing great, and you?
All right, I'm doing great.
So We're live
on YouTube. People around the world can watch us do this. Okay, again, Amparo joined us. So let me just remind everybody on Verbling, if you are watching this video, then you can join by clicking on the Join Class button. If you are not yet a Verbling member and you want to join these classes, we have classes all day, every day, pretty much, then you do need to become a member, and then you can come and join us and get to know people from around the world and practice your English at the same time. Okay, so here we go. I'm going to give you guys the link also to this so you can see it on your own computer if you want. I'm going to probably should make it bigger also because it's kind of hard to see when it's only size 11. All right, so I just created some of these to get us started. We can come up with other ones if we want. Some of these down here, I grabbed this one from another website, so it's a little bit more information. But this is role-playing, so I think you guys are pretty familiar with that. It's just a chance to give you guys a little bit of opportunity to speak to each other and kind of improvise and just make it up. And like, you know, we're simulating real-life experiences and how to use English in real ways, different situations are, so here we go. So here's one that's an employer-employee role play. So the first one is somebody's going to be the employer. The thing is that you're very unhappy with your employee because he or she, whatever, keeps showing up 30 minutes late to work. So you're having problems. So, you know, that you, the person who's going to play this, think about how that affects your company perhaps, the office, the other employees, how it affects you, and how you want to speak to that employee about it. Are you going to give them a consequence? Are you going to give them a warning? What do you expect? And then the employee who does show up late to work, so there's not like an argument about that, but you have a good reason, and you have to be able to tell your boss, convince your boss that this is a good reason, and maybe, I don't know, maybe you want to say you should start a half an hour later anyways, and somehow you guys are going to work out a solution. But let's help this person out first. So what could be some possible reasons why a person would show up 30 minutes late every day?
Rush hour.
Rush? Rush hour?
Yes.
Yeah, so rush hour or traffic, so it's just too difficult to get to work on time, all right? What would be another reason why somebody would come late to work 30 minutes every day?
Maybe to get the children's to school or how should I say?
You have to get the children off to school. Maybe maybe something like you're supposed to be at work at 9 o'clock, but the kids have to be at school at 9 o'clock, so you can't really take them to school early. You know, something like that.
Like if you had to take your child to school every day.
Yeah.
Should walk with him because it's not safe. Something like that.
Something like that. Okay. So, yeah, you could have like safety concerns for your children.
Yeah.
We can say also personal engagement, personal commitment.
Okay. So another one might be you have some personal things you have to do every day. like commitments. Whoops. Commitments. Yep.
Or all right. Staying awake for, yeah.
Anybody else have another idea?
Yeah.
What?
Stay awake for a long time, preparing for your job in the morning. Could be like that.
Preparing for your job. All right. So you're working more even, but you're just not doing it at work, something like that.
We are good in finding excuses.
Again, I'm finding excuses. Okay, all right. So I'm just a good excuse finder. Okay, good.
And Lisa, can we say long arguments between husband and wife?
Okay, so you have marital conflicts.
Yes.
So every morning you have to fight with your wife or your husband before you go to work.
Yes, for example, my wife puts the tea on the stove lately, so I cannot have my breakfast, then I can be late for the work.
Okay, all right. So maybe your boss will be understanding about that, huh? Let you come
yes,
in later.
So it depends on my boss. For example, if my boss is Amparo, she can understand me.
Really? Okay. I don't know. Maybe Amparo is going to be a tough boss.
Yeah, that is not excuses.
That's not a good excuse. Okay. All right, so who wants to be the employer? Anybody want to be the employer?
I'll take that.
Who said that? Ahmad?
Yeah.
Okay, Ahmad, you're the employer, and who wants to be the employee who has a good reason why you're late?
I'll take it.
Okay, I'll take it. Good. Okay, Ahmad, so why don't you pretend like you're calling your employee into the office and you want to, let them know that this is unacceptable, blah, blah, blah. Okay,
Can you please borrow, can I please borrow you for a minute to speak like in private in my office?
Okay.
That's good.
Let's
go. So, you've probably noticed that we're all upset, not only just me, everyone in the company here upset that you are always coming 30 minutes late to work. Why is that?
I just want to correct your information. It is not always, it is sometimes, because I have some personal commitments. I have to take my children to school at 9 o'clock, and since we start working at 9:15, I can't really be there in 15 minutes. Also, it's because of traffic, and the company don't give me any repayment for my traffic, so I have to pay all the traffic and the bus. And it is really expensive, so we really need to find a solution for that.
We have 2 points. First, you are actually talking about argument about things that we already agreed about when we first hired you, employed you. This is not acceptable now. It's something that we can't argue about right now. This is from like just one hand. The other hand, we're talking about things like circumstances that will be always like that for a long time. If you know that you will be always late for 30 minutes every day, if you are a good worker, you're supposed to come to me first and discuss the problem with me. Not being just always late, then when I ask you about the problem, you just give me an excuse for it.
Yes,
right?
You are right.
So if you have a problem with the traffic, and if you are not able to get here on time every day, then you are supposed, as a good worker, and I think you are a good worker, you're supposed to discuss this problem with each other, yes? Right? And
I should have told you this at the beginning because I had some personal problems I'm divorcing right now, so I have really some additional responsibilities for the children, and I'm really going through a very hard time. So I think I will appreciate I will really appreciate it if you can just understand this for just one more month, and I promise you that I will improve my work and try to be on time. Okay.
First, let's talk about what you have been through until now. To tell you the truth, I'm really satisfied by your productivity, and you are a good worker with me. Here in the company, I would never argue your ability and your eligibility. But being late for that, I didn't spoke about the past. I didn't, like, this is the first time I talk about your problem being late. I just waited for that long time to see if you have good, like, you might be, like, have some good reasons. But after knowing that, like, what I've learned now from you about your excuse, it's not possible. And you are asking for even for 1 month. Okay, I think the only way that we could make, like, compromise the problem by cutting off from your salary. We'll see how much it will be. If it's not that big of a deal, okay, I'll make it for free for you. I won't charge it. But if it's like more than 30 minutes a day, I'm sorry, I'm gonna like take I will charge it from your salary. I take it off from your salary, mm-hmm. And you might probably notice that at the end of the month.
Okay. I like that. You might notice that.
I think I have a better solution. Since our company is offering the possibility of working with a flexible time, I think I will just add 30 minutes of work after 7 p.m. so I can really work the 30 minutes that I missed in the morning.
Yeah.
And this way, I will really be doing my full hours of the day, and you don't have to take off money of my salary. Okay?
Yeah, you can make up this 30 minutes.
Okay. Yeah. Good. All right. Anybody have any feedback for these guys? I think it was good. Was Imad a fair boss?
Was Imad a devil?
Yes. I told them I'm going through a divorce and I have really serious personal problems, but he didn't understand.
Good.
Evil boss.
Evil boss.
And angel employer.
Yeah. Angel. Yeah. I thought the funniest one was when you said that you might notice. That was a funny way to say it. It was very, like, I'm going to take off, and you might notice you won't have as much money anymore or something. That was good. Okay, all right, good. Thank you for that. Okay, so here's another one. We're going to go through some, and then if we go through them fast enough and we have time, we'll go back and have other people play the same ones, and it'll create a different scene. But in this case, let's go to a doctor and a patient. So one person is going to be the patient, and you're going to see the doctor. And the reason why you're going there is because you want to lose some weight. And that's the reason why you're seeing the doctor. And the doctor is going to listen to you, and then he's going to start giving you some ideas on how you can lose weight. But in the conversation, we want to have for a little while a dialogue going back and forth, kind of in a real way. So you might include some of the things that you've already tried to lose weight, and then the doctor can give you some feedback about, you know, why it worked or why it didn't work, and maybe what you can do now. So what would be some possible ways that a person could lose some weight? that they've either tried or the doctor might tell them.
Sorry, go back and forth in a real way. What does it mean?
Oh, yeah, go back and forth in a real way. So in the conversation, you're going to talk to each other back and forth. So that means, yeah, just like a dialogue, you know.
Question and answer.
Yeah, right. Or just that, not necessarily even a question to answer, but just one person talking, making comments, and you know,
in a
real way. So you know, to prepare yourself mentally to do this, try to put yourself in a real situation, like you're going to the doctor. What would a doctor really say, and what would a patient really say? That's what I meant there.
Sorry, I see.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So what would be some possible ways that a person could try to lose weight?
Go to workout.
Okay, hold on. One at a time. Alexandra, what'd you say?
I was saying to put a lock on the fridge.
Okay, lack of self-control.
Especially at night. Especially at night.
All right, so especially that's the abbreviation for especially at night. All right, Amparo, did you have one?
Change your diet.
Change your diet? Like anything in particular?
Forget junk food.
What?
Forget junk food.
Okay, so we can say stop eating junk food. All right. What else? Did somebody else have an idea?
Yes, I have one. Going to work out.
Uh-huh. Okay, so exercise maybe?
Yes, exercise.
Workout.
Especially physical exercise.
Sure, yeah. Physical exercise. So maybe go work out at the gym, go running, something like that.
Jogging. Like
jogging,
that.
Yeah. Okay. Anybody else have an idea?
Eat Japanese food.
Don't eat between meals. Schedule.
Okay. So eat a Japanese diet food.
Yes. And eat rice as a staple diet, staple food.
Okay, so rice. And what do you say, Ate? Don't eat between meals?
Eat rice as
a schedule. To have a schedule with to eat.
Okay.
I have a good way. All right. Join Verbling. Always hungry.
Join Verbling, but don't go to classes that talk about food.
Yeah.
And Lisa studying many academic or normal important exams.
Oh, study for exams. Yeah, study. Yes. How about just like study, and then forget about eating?
For example, I start to gain the weight because of that.
Because of studying?
Yes, I mean, I will take one academic exam next Sunday.
Yeah.
And now my weight raised 1 kilogram.
Oh, so that's not a way to lose weight, then that's a way to gain weight, huh?
Yes.
Okay,
sometimes it can be opposite thing for some people.
Sure.
If they are stressed, they cannot eat something, so they can lose their weight.
Oh, I see. Yes. Exactly. I understand that. Any other ideas?
Join the army.
Join the army. Yeah, join the army and go to basic training, and they'll make you lose some weight.
Go to jail as well.
Okay, sure. Why don't you just go to jail?
Kill somebody.
Just spend some time in jail.
But this sentence or this situation is opposite for my country, because some poor people try to go to jail because the government supports to free meal and very good meals for these people make some many things. I mean, for example, they steal a little bit money for others, and they go to jail and they eat very, very yummy meals.
Yeah, I've wondered about that before. If you were so poor and you couldn't support yourself or feed yourself. You might just do some little crime and get thrown in jail for a while, and you could have a bed and have 3 meals a day, and have. Sometimes you could even have classes and all kinds of stuff. But it's not usually the route you want to go. So
yes.
Usually people like having freedom more. Okay, so who would like to be the doctor? Oh no, we lost Alexandra.
I can be the doctor.
Okay, all right. Amparo, you're the doctor. Who wants to be Hamid or Yuki?
Yes, I want to be patient.
Okay, all right. So Hamid, you're going to the doctor, and so you can walk in, or either way, doctor, you can call him into your office and ask him what it is that he wants today. Why is he there to see you? Okay, so Amparo will start by inviting you into her office.
Come in.
Hello, ma'am. How are you? I'm okay. What about you?
I'm fine, thank you. Why are you visiting today?
Actually, I have some problems with my weight.
Yes, I can see. The last time I saw you, I think you have at least you have increased 20 pounds.
Yes, unfortunately, and I tried many. I tried several methods, but unfortunately, it doesn't work for me.
Yes, I think you have to follow.
Whoops, Amparo, your microphone went out.
Yeah, it's better.
Yeah, now it's better.
Okay. You have to follow a plan, and you have to be disciplined. If you have any food in the middle of the usual food, you are going to increase your weight. Are you eating a lot of chocolate, bread?
Miss Doctor, I tried, for example, I put a lock for my bridge. I changed my diet, and I received the low calorie foods. And
jumping a meal doesn't mean that you are going to lose weight easily. That is just your liver is going to work slowly. So it doesn't help. You have to distribute your food in five meals during the day, and in that way you are not going to get a lot of calories. So we are going to establish your diet for the 7 days of the day, and you have to combine the diet between beans and fruits and vegetables.
Okay, and I also changed my physical exercise program. I mean, for example, in beginning, I will try 10 kilometers every day by jogging, some half jogging and half running. But nowadays, I increased the distance as 15 kilometers in a day.
Yeah, but I think you don't have to push yourself too much. You first need to start doing walk 30 minutes, because if you run with this overweight that you have, you are going to have several damage in your knees. So start with walking, and then we are increasing the activities.
Okay, and I also look at my eatings. For this, my one Japanese friend, his name is Yuki. He advised
my method. Oh.
Is he a doctor?
It is a great honor. Thank you.
He advised me to eat Japanese food because there is no high oil or like that. So also nowadays My one of favorite foods are sushi. For example, after this lesson, Yuki and I will go to sushi restaurant.
You can eat everything, but you have to take small portions of everything. That is the problem. You are taking more than that you need. So that is why we are going to establish your plan for you. And yes. I hope that you follow the plan in the way that I am going to tell you. And so I hope to see you in a month. And at least you have to lose, if you follow the pattern, maybe 5 or 8 pounds.
I see. So last time, Yuki ate 5 sushi.
Don't stay too much time in front of your computer and mm-hmm. try to work out more.
Okay. I see. So I made a mistake, Miss Doctor. In this my mistake, Yuki ate 5 sushis, but I ate 7 sushis. It was a very big mistake.
You eat more than me.
Yes. So my weight is improving, increasing.
Good.
But difference is not so big.
Yeah, forget okay. about forget about the dessert, ice cream, chocolate. Just
okay, Miss. And I have also another problem. You know, I am jobless. So I am studying, and I should find a work. So what is your advice for this?
You are going to get a gastritis, and that is another issue.
Okay, maybe I should go to a psychiatry doctor.
Maybe he should go to a psychiatric doctor.
Psychiatric.
Yes, that is my specialty.
Okay, I see. So, thank you.
Money in different doctors. Traumatologists, nutritionists, psychiatrists.
And my other problem is I noticed and I discovered one good website to improve my some abilities, especially my foreign language abilities. This website is Verblink. And I am in front of the computer like maybe 5 or 6 hours in a day. So it is another big mistake. I see.
Yeah, I told you. You can't spend too much.
Yeah.
In front of the computer.
Okay, Miss Doctor. See my mistakes and I will change myself absolutely. I believe in that. thanks to you and my ambition, I will give maybe 16 pounds in 1 month.
Okay, I'll see you in a month then. Follow the plan.
Okay. Thank you for your advices and helping Miss Doctor. See you later. Bye.
Bye.
Good. All right, that was great. How did you guys feel about doing that?
I think both played their role very well.
Yes.
I was surprised that AMP has a very I was surprised of the advice AMP gave him. It sounds very professional.
Yes, you sounded like a doctor, yes. Amparo.
Sound like
I
doctor.
Have two sisters that are.
Oh really?
Really?
Two of my sisters are doctors.
For you giving so, such a advice.
Is that how
she has the genetics of a doctor.
Yeah. Is that how they talk to you?
Yes. My sisters are doctors, so I know something.
Yeah, sounded very professional.
Oh, it's very
cool.
Practical and useful advice.
Yeah. What
For us.
What kind of doctors are they?
One is nephrologist, and the another is clinical doctor.
Oh, okay. Wow. Cool. Do they speak English too?
No.
No. So you just hear it in Spanish.
Yeah, just in Spanish.
Okay, cool. All right, well, that was a good job, you guys. How many? You did great. You kept coming with all the different things. That was good. Kept it going.
Yes, and I also tried to some funny things.
Yes, they were way, funny.
Yes, with this way, I can be useful and good ways to keep some things in our minds.
Yeah. Yeah, it was great. That was good. All right, so here's another scenario. There's a father and a son, and the father is upset with the son for coming home late 3 nights in a row. The father wants to know what has been going on with the son, and the son needs to explain why he has been coming home so late the last couple of nights. So what could be some reasons why you would be coming home late at night if you're a young boy?
Hanging out with
Okay, hold on. One person at a time. Yuki, go ahead. Hanging out with his friends
until late.
Okay, yeah. All right. Maybe doing something specific, like watching a movie or, you know, something. What else did you say, Ate?
I was just saying the first excuse that don't give to the parents is studying with friends.
Studying with friends, yeah. What else? Ahmad, have any ideas? What would be a good reason to come home late?
A good reason? Smoking cigarettes.
I don't think he's going to like to hear that one. You might not want to tell your dad that.
Yeah, this is the worst excuse ever.
Yeah. I didn't say smoking like heroin or cocaine. I don't know. It's a smoke.
Okay, how about he's learning cannabis. How to smoke? Yeah, Ahmad?
I have another one.
Ahmad, what?
But firstly, if the father is understanding,
yeah,
the son says, I was meeting with my girlfriend.
Sure. With my girlfriend. Yeah. Okay.
In private.
All right. What, what did you say, Ate?
I said he would understand what was going.
Yeah, he'll make an inference on that one.
Yeah.
Infer a meaning. Yuki?
Being interested in the biology, all night he followed the bat.
Followed the bugs?
Bat.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Bat.
Followed bat. So he's like a budding scientist, and he's so excited about what he's learning that he has to stay up late to follow the bats.
And another thing, being interested in chemistry. From periodic table.
Doing what?
Periodic table.
Oh, studying the periodic table.
Table. Yes, there are 118 elements. So he can try to explain element symbols for his friend. I mean, they can try to memorize the element symbols, so it can take too much time.
Yeah, that can take a long time.
No, these are nerd excuses.
Nerd excuses.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. What about working? Maybe he got a job and he's working.
Getting a part-time job of security guard.
Okay.
It is very convincing.
A new project.
New project?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Maybe
like he's working on a new project somewhere away from the house, so some at friend's house or something.
Oh, I see.
Yeah. And if their home is not internet, maybe he can go to any friend's home and they can join verbling lessons or other activities from internet.
Maybe looking for his own real parents.
Why he don't use? Why he don't use at home? Internet.
No, there's no internet at the house.
Maybe they are poor.
Yeah, they're poor. Okay, Imad, did you have another one?
Yeah, looking or searching for his own real parents because I don't believe that this was like, his own real parents.
Okay. All right, searching for his real parents.
He was assaulted.
Three nights in a row? Salted every night.
They stole the money, and so he has to work. For a long.
Okay, so he has to walk now. Okay. Yeah. All right. He's so those Barbara. Are some good ideas. So let's see what you guys come up with. You don't have to use all of those. Those are just to get your mind thinking about some creative ways that you could make this dialogue happen. So who would like to be the father and who would like to be the son? Yuki, you haven't done one yet. Would you like to be the father or the son?
It's very difficult.
you get to be, if you're the father, you can decide if you're going
it
to
is
be...
all the same for me.
Okay. So
maybe choose.
You can be the father.
Let my partner choose.
Now you can. Okay, who wants to be the father or son?
I want to be son.
Okay, so you can be the father, and you get to decide if you're going to be a very loving, caring, generous father or a dictator.
Dictator.
A mean father. You get to decide.
I'll be.
Well, don't tell us yet. Don't tell us. You'll tell us by how you talk to your son. So call your son, I don't know, into your room or something, and then ask him what has been going on.
Okay.
All
right. I'll be who I'll be?
You're the father.
Father, okay.
Mm-hmm. Hamid's the son.
Hamid, sit down here. I'd like to talk with you in person. Okay?
What is the problem?
To say the truth, I'm very anxious about you. Recently, you come home quite late. In this week, you every day you come home after midnight. So what has been going on with you?
Firstly, that you don't give my pocket money.
I don't give you pocket money. No, yes? I give you every month. I give you enough money to buy textbooks and for lunch. So,
but it is not enough. It is not enough for me. And you know, I wanted, and thank you for that. You bought a good new mobile phone, but unfortunately, my credit finishes immediately. So how can I save my pocket money for next month?
Do you think so? I think you. You live a quite luxury life. I think you have to economy your money. And let me know what do you do every day in night until late.
Nowadays, I met some good friends, and we are studying some lessons, especially one friend, his name is James. James are good at biology, and Alex is good at chemistry. So, for example, you can test me. I can learn the follow-up bets and periodic table. Like, also, I learned some easy experiments. Mm. And if you give permission for me, I will try to do some experiments in the home.
So you say you every night you study with your James, yeah, your friend.
I was in James' home, and Alex was joining to us to help and learn between us, and we are good learning and eager team for especially scientific lessons.
Mm-hmm. I see. It would be nice if it was a true story, but I am suspicious of your story. Your teacher in the school called me and yes. reported that he found you in the night and he said that you often hanged out with your friend in the street in the night cafe night club. I don't want to believe your teacher's story, but my son, please tell the truth.
Okay, Dad, I will say the truth. It was only one night, we were unlucky. I mean, because
unlucky.
When we were in the outside,
yes.
it was interesting moment for us. We saw our teacher in the same nightclub.
What did you say? Same what?
Same nightclub.
Yes.
So our teacher doesn't follow us. He also joins the nightclubs for every night.
I'd like to believe your story, but even one night, I think you enjoyed the time in night bar. So I am anxious about that. It lead to long way of your school life. Don't you want to repeat it again? Don't you want to go there again?
Okay, that I promise I won't go to again. But you know, I am a teen, so sometimes I need to recharge for some activities. I know it was a very big mistake, and I promise I will do not again.
Okay, you are good, son. I have no comment more. So promise to me if you will be late at night, please call me. Yeah, and beforehand, call me and tell me your schedule. Okay.
Okay, and you know that we have some financial problems. For this, we had no internet. For this, I went to James' home. They have wonderful, very quick, very fast internet. We were working in our new project. Mm-hmm. And also, you can ask their parents. I am telling lie or not. And another proof. You can smell my shirt. Maybe you heard some things from other neighbors, and they only gossip for you, and they don't say real. I mean, I don't know how to smoke. I don't know what is the cigarette.
I become believe you. Your words. Indeed, you are quite a good son for me. You study in school very well. Your result of exams is excellent, and you do a housework often. You often help us housework. I think I love you very much. So please don't make me worry about you.
Yeah, okay? Don't give your dad a heart attack.
okay. That and I have other thing. This other thing is I want to support our family financially. For this, I discovered one course. This course is a security guard course. And the time is only night times, so please understand me. I was coming lately for this course.
Of course, doing a part-time job as a security guard is a good experience. But I am worried about you. Okay, try. Yeah. Only I. My son, Hamid, I love you very much. Let me kiss you.
Okay, I love you too, Dede, and I promise and understand me for my mistakes. They are very big mistakes, I know. Sorry again.
Promise, don't make me disappoint. Okay?
Okay, Dede, I promise you.
Don't disappoint me. Don't disappoint me.
Okay.
Yeah. Good job, okay. You guys. Okay. So, Imad was saying, Ampara, he was a puppet.
Turn around.
Yeah,
puppet he had a puppet. What does it mean, puppet?
It means that the father is.
Calm it.
It's not that big. Yeah, he changed your mind, like he completely turned you around, and you were angry, and then become.
Yeah. He was a very loving father.
You was about to ask for, beg for pardon to your son.
Yeah, and very loving father is another way of saying very full. But being very, very. Mm-hmm. Very good with your son in a way that you believe everything. Like you changed your mind completely. I don't know how to say it.
Yeah, you had a turnaround, or you had.
Yeah.
So what do you think
I think it was good. I think it was good. I think it was realistic. I mean, depending on the type of father that you are, I mean, a lot of times you want to believe your kids and you want, you know, it sounded like the most thing was that he just was worried and he just didn't want to be worried about him doing something that would be dangerous or something like that, but mostly he trusted him.
I think you often see such a father.
Yeah.
Like me. Yeah.
Yeah. No. Yeah. I mean, especially Hamid sounded believable. You know, yeah. Like he didn't sound like he was being mean or something or trying to lie too much. He just kind of was coming up with crazy ideas, though.
He's a too good to son. He's a too good to son.
But he was lying.
I do not do anything.
But he sounded convincing, so.
Yes, I'd like to scold, but I couldn't.
You couldn't, yeah.
Yes.
Because he was when he told you he was studying, you know, that's a good idea to be you support that.
Yes, and I tried to use every explanations, so
yeah.
The scenario is a little bit hard, but I guess I used all explanations.
Yeah, you used all the ones we came up with. Yeah, that was good.
I think Hamito is a really good son.
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you.
All right, so we only have a couple more minutes. Why don't we just finish up with Imad and Amparo? Why don't you guys, this is a kind of can be a simple one. It's just a straightforward, like a telephone call. So Amparo, why don't you be the customer, and you're going to be having a party later tonight, and you want to order a bunch of pizzas and maybe some drinks or something like that, but you want to make sure that they're going to be ready for you to or be delivered, I guess, by 5 p.m. So you have to give them the details about what kind of pizza you want, what size, that kind of thing. And then Imad, as the pizza delivery person, you need to make sure you take down all of her information, ask her name, her directions, and tell her what the price is going to be and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
Okay, so you're going to answer the phone because she's calling you. So ring, ring, ring. And Imad, you answer the phone.
Hi. No. Pizza
Hello.
Hut.
Pizza Hut.
I need you help me with 5 pizza for today. It is possible at 5 p.m.
You want them... Like the medium size or the large size? Which size do you want?
The large size.
Large size? You want it?
Yeah. One of them, Hawaiian, with pineapple.
Mm-hmm.
Mushrooms.
Yeah.
The another one, I prefer salami with pieces of cheese, yellow cheese, and mozzarella. With oregano. I don't know what the another kind
do you want me,
could be.
Yeah, do you have some special offers? Do you want me to tell you about them?
Nice.
What about them?
We have
olive?
Family. Yeah, we have the family pizza today. It's very large. It could be like equal to that, like two large size pizza, and it's like it has extra cheese and it's thick. Mean the dough
thick crust.
Thick. Yeah,
okay.
And you have the choice. You can add anything. Like one extra choice, to add one thing from your choice, anything.
Okay, it sounds good. We can have a olive then.
Okay, you can add
pepper,
some meat.
Red pepper, mm-hmm. Red pepper,
yeah, okay.
Tomatoes.
Yeah,
but I need that you be on time because I don't like the cold food.
Yeah. Do you want anything spicy?
Yes.
Any one of them?
Pepperonis, pepper, chili pepper.
Okay. Yeah. Anything else like appetizers, soft drink, soda, anything?
Yeah, soda. It's okay. I
you
need a. Three bottles of 1 liter.
Mm-hmm.
3 liters, but not black one. I prefer white or strawberry.
Yeah, okay.
So
that? Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay. Another thing, do you want me to add anything to your order? Like, you have another options. You can check them out from the internet website, you know, our website.
Garlic bread.
Garlic, yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Garlic bread.
Mm. Okay, I'll submit your order under the name of Amparo, and you can call me if you want to change your order in the next 50 minutes. Otherwise, it will be delivered.
No, it's okay. That is the order that I am going to take.
Mm-hmm. You just confirm your order, and that's it. Thank you very much.
Okay, great, you guys. That was awesome. All right. Once again, we ended up with some food, so now I'm gonna go have lunch. But that was really good, and I liked Ahmad especially how you kept adding, asking her, "Would you like to add something else, like you know, meat or something?" And you gave her information about your specials. So
that sounded make some money. You know.
Yeah, exactly.
That's where the money comes from.
Yeah, that's called upselling. Would you like to add fries with that? That's what they say at McDonald's or something. Would you like to have a Coca-Cola or something? So good job. Okay, guys. Well, thanks for joining. I'm glad you guys participated. It's always fun hearing you guys come up with the scenes, making the scenes, and you guys did a really good job. So.
Thank you so much.
Bye, everybody. Classes all day, every day, pretty much. Then you do need to become a member, and then you can come and join us and get to know people from around the world and practice your English at the same time. Okay, so here we go. I'm going to give you guys the link also to this so you can see it on your own computer if you want. I'm going to probably should make it bigger also because it's kind of hard to see when it's only size 11. All right, so I just created some of these to get us started. We can come up with other ones if we want. Some of these down here, I grabbed this one from another website, so it's a little bit more information. But this is role-playing, so I think you guys are pretty familiar with that. It's just a chance to give you guys a little bit of opportunity to speak to each other and kind of improvise and just make it up. And like, you know, we're simulating real-life experiences and how to use English in real ways, different situations. So here we go. So here's one that's an employer-employee role play. So the first one is somebody's going to be the employer. The thing is that you're very unhappy with your employee because he or she, whatever, keeps showing up 30 minutes late to work. So you're having problems. So, you know, that you, the person who's going to play this, think about how that affects your company perhaps, the office, the other employees. How it affects you, and how you want to speak to that employee about it. Are you going to give them a consequence? Are you going to give them a warning? What do you expect? And then the employee who does show up late to work, so there's not like an argument about that, but you have a good reason, and you have to be able to tell your boss, convince your boss that this is a good reason, and maybe I don't know, maybe you want to say you should start a half an hour later anyways, and somehow you guys are going to work out a solution. But let's help this person out first. So what could be some possible reasons why a person would show up 30 minutes late every day?
Rush hour.
Rush? Rush hour?
Okay. We're live.
We're live now. All right. Hi, everybody. Welcome to another Verbling class. This is going to be a speaking class. But instead of just talking and having a conversation, we're going to let you guys do some role-playing. So I've created a few scenarios where we'll get a little bit of background information, and then you guys will take turns playing different roles and improvising. So you're going to be making some stuff up, but we're also going to help you guys
So if you get stuck, we can provide some things for you to consider. So let me go to, let's see here, who's, hello. Hi there, Ate, how are you?
I'm doing great, and you?
All right, I'm doing great.
Okay. So,
We're live on YouTube. People around the world can watch us do this. Okay, good, Amparo joined us. So let me just remind everybody on Verbling, if you are watching this video, then you can join by clicking on the Join Class button. If you are not yet a Verbling member and you want to join these classes, we have Clara?
Yes.
Yeah, so rush hour or traffic, so it's just too difficult to get to work on time, all right? What would be another reason why somebody would come late to work 30 minutes every day?
Maybe to get the children's to school or how should I say?
You have to get the children off to school. Maybe something like you're supposed to be at work at 9 o'clock, but the kids have to be at school at 9 o'clock, so you can't really take them to school early, you know, something like that.
If you had to take your child to school every day, yeah, should walk with him because it's not safe. Something like that.
Something like that. Okay. So, yeah, you can have like safety concerns for your children.
Yeah. We can say also personal engagement, personal commitment.
Okay. So another one might be you have some personal things you have to do every day, like commitments. Whoops. Commitments. Yep.
Or
all right.
Staying awake for,
anybody else have another idea?
Yeah.
What?
Stay awake for a long time, preparing for your job in the morning. Could be like that.
Preparing for your job. All right. So you're working more even, but you're just not doing it at work, something like that.
We are good in finding excuses.
Again, I'm finding excuses. Okay, all right. So I'm just a good excuse finder. Okay, good.
And Lisa, can we say long arguments between husband and wife?
Okay, so you have marital conflicts.
Yes.
So every morning you have to fight with your wife or your husband before you go to work.
Yes, for example, my wife puts the tea on the stove lately, so I cannot have